Son, give you praise, oh God, for you are worthy of the praise, oh God, we will lift our hands to you, oh God.
Oh God,
for you are worthy of our praise.
Oh God,
everybody lift your voice, your name is Yahweh.
Oh God,
your name is Yahweh. Oh God, your name is Yahweh. Oh God, your name is Yahweh. Oh God, my God, your name is Yahweh. Oh God, everybody lift your voice, your name is Yahweh.
Oh God,
your name
is Yahweh.
In heaven and on the earth,
Oh God,
your name is Yahweh. Oh God, hallelujah.
Your name is Yahweh. Oh God,
your name is Yahweh. Oh God, mighty Redeemer, your name is Yahweh. Oh God, my God, your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is higher than every other name. Your name is Abba. Your name is Savior. Miracle Keeper. Your name is Abba. Your name is Savior. Your name is higher than every other name. Your name. Your name is Savior, Miracle King God. Your name
is Yahweh.
Lift your voice and say,
Oh God.
In heaven and earth is His name. The living of the valley is His name. Your name is Yahweh. From eternity to eternity, Savior, your name. Lift up your voice. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. Adonai is His name. Jehovah, Jireh, the King of Glory. I am that I am. His name. Your name is Yahweh. Hallelujah.
Oh God.
Mighty Redeemer.
Your name is Yahweh.
In heaven, your name is Yahweh.
Oh God.
Your name is Yahweh. Oh God, my God. Your name is Yahweh.
Your name is Yahweh.
Your name is Yahweh.
Oh yes, hallelujah.
Oh God.
Oh God.
Oh God.
Yes, shout for praise is His name.
Your name is Yahweh.
The Lord of the valley is His name. The castle. Oh God. My Christ Redeemer, your name is
Yahweh.
In the situation that I'm passing through, in my family, in my career,
your name is Yahweh.
Oh, yes, your name, your name, your name, your name. Yes, your name is Yahweh. Oh God.
Oh God,
your name is Yahweh. Oh, shadow, praise your name is Yahweh.
Oh God.
I say your name is Yahweh.
Yeah.
Oh yes, hallelujah. We lift up our voices.
Oh,
we lift up our voices. We lift up our. Your name is Yahweh.
Your name is Yahweh.
Oh, on a gentle basis, your name.
Oh God.
Oh God. Your name is Yahweh.
Your name is
Yahweh. Mighty Redeemer, your name is Yahweh.
Oh God.
Somebody say Yahweh. Somebody shout
Yahweh.
Oh Yahweh, 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 Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. Somebody say hey. Somebody say Yahweh. Somebody say Yahweh. Yahweh, 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 Yahweh,
Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh,
and then at the beginning of this month, God gave a direction and declared it our month of amazing peace. Praise Master Jesus. And mommy has gone into details to tell us what peace is about, gone into details to explain to us why we need peace, went into certain, you know, weighty matters of the spirit to let us understand that peace is completely inevitable in the life of man. And just this evening, I want to tour on that path to just bring us to the point where we understand one or two things again about peace. Hallelujah. It was Brother Job who said something in the book of Job chapter 14 in verse 1. He said, man is born of a woman. But this man born of a woman has short days to live on earth. And in these short days, his life is full of trouble. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the reason why we need peace. The life we live is encumbered with one problem or the other. If you're not facing economical crisis, you might be facing financial crisis. If you're not facing financial crisis, you might be facing health crisis. If you're not facing health crisis, it is possible you are facing rejection crisis. No wonder most people are tilting towards, you know, what we call depression. We explain it as depression. But that particular ailment or development is as a result of, you know, lack of peace. When peace is not available, anything can become a crisis. Now, what God does with peace was to ensure peace becomes a checkmate to the crisis of life. The day you said, Jesus, I follow you. I confess you as my Lord and personal Savior. You confessed by faith. No wonder in the book of Ephesians chapter 2, if you read from verse 8, it said, for by faith are you saved. It said, for by grace are you saved through faith. It said, and that's not of yourself, not of works. It is the gift of God. It said, for by grace are you saved through faith. And that not of yourself, it is the gift of God, not of works, verse 9. It said, not of works, move to verse 9. Not of works, lest any man should boast. So the day you made that confession, you already had a currency called faith. Faith is the currency with which we purchase in the realm of the spirit. So no man can ever be righteous except he is righteous by faith. You are righteous by the finished work. That is a topic for another day. Now, Apostle Paul tries to establish something here. He said, faith is the currency with which we possess. Now, in the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 22, I am treating today the topic I have captioned, the five attackers of peace, or the five consumers of peace. Galatians 5:16, he said, this I say then, walk ye in the spirit. Walk ye in the spirit. Mark that word, in the spirit. And ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Walk ye in the spirit. I will tell you something after this. Go ahead. Verse 17. It said, for the flesh lusteth against the spirit. There is a contention. The flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. These are contrary one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. There is a contention between the flesh and the spirit. Let me quickly explain this before I forget. Now, if you watch in the book of Genesis chapter 1, in verse 28, the Bible says, and God blessed them and said, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, have dominion and subdue it. That was the 5-point mandate agenda God gave to man. But God realized after creating man that a spirit cannot have dominion. A spirit cannot procreate. A spirit cannot occupy the earth. When he addressed man in the book of Genesis chapter 1, in verse 28, he was addressing a man that was in his likeness. Hallelujah. He was addressing them, man and woman he had made, you know, but they were spirits. They could not be tangible to time. Now coming to chapter 2 in verse 7. Give me Genesis chapter 2 in verse 7. In verse 7, the Bible says, and God formed man from the dust of the earth. Remember, he created man in Genesis chapter 1. And in chapter 2, he said, and the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils. That means man first existed as creation in spirit. I am trying to balance what Apostle Paul is trying to tell us in the New Testament. He said, and he breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. This was when the dominion mandate got complete. Now, at this point, it is quite established that man who is originally made a spirit has to also exist in the spirit in order to have dominion in both the spirit, and then needed to be in flesh, body, bones, and blood put together by the Almighty, that he breathed in. And carried that breath he breathed was to carry the spirit and put into man. And that is why the moment the spirit leaves, what goes back to the grave is the dust from which this body of you and I were made from. Is God talking to somebody here? So the dominion mandate had to begin a journey. The replenishment mandate had to begin a journey because spirit will not replenish. The multiplicator mandate has to begin a journey because spirit will not multiply. Flesh has to meet with flesh to produce another flesh. So God put man into flesh. Now, right from Genesis chapter 2, there has been a constant war between flesh and the spirit. Man has always had this struggle. And that is why Apostle Paul wrote in this particular letter to the Galatian church in verse 17, he said, the spirit and the flesh are always at war. But eventually, he suggested something. He said, be in the spiritual. Give me verse 16 again. Let's leave that verse. This I say then, walk ye in the spirit, because there is a war. Do you know that it takes very little effort to live in the flesh, but takes much more to be able to occupy in the spirit? It takes a lot more effort to be in spirit than to be in flesh. Flesh doesn't take anything. And that is why flesh will always react when it sees obscene scenarios. Flesh will always react whenever what entices it is shown to it. Just keep the scripture there. Just keep it there. Let it be my background, no problem. So he said, then walk ye in the spirit, and walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. In other words, the spirit is meant to be a check to the flesh. The presence of the spirit puts a check on the flesh. And that is why if you are living your life totally in flesh, you have almost been miserable. When you can no longer command the flesh to keep it calm, from the realms of the spirit, you are lost. When you gave your life to Christ, what was activated was spirit. And this was done by a process comport. In fact, as you even they no greet you again, you go peace three times, come back. There is always a check. That thing that you would by flesh, the spirit checks it. Sometimes the thing you would by spirit, the flesh is combating to make sure you don't do it. Go and put that seed on the altar. Some of you now, the spirit of God, go and put that money on the altar. And they don't like, no be your last transport. If you put them, how you go take go? Give me verse 18. But if ye be led of the spirit, you are not under the law. Because the flesh is full of the laws. If ye now operate under the spirit, the law of the flesh does not put you bound. Say, you get erection, and if something must calm the erection, then that's the law of the flesh. The spirit can tell the flesh, put your face on the ground. And what will the flesh do? It go face ground. Give me verse 19. Now the works of the flesh are manifest. Now the works of the flesh are manifest. I'm just building a small introduction. I'm coming somewhere. Now the works of the flesh are manifest. Which are these? Adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred. Take note of this point now. Take note of this. This next one now, after witchcraft. Hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, sedition, heresies, envyings. Igbo call it ebueta. Eta. Ebueta, envying. Then they ask you, waiting, they make you dry up like this. Say, hey, they fasting. Don't be fasting, not bitterness. You know they sleep. Huh? The brother buy new car, your mind caught. Why will he buy car? Me, we don't suffer. Why will he buy car? You are dying. The man is making his progress. Somebody share ordinary testimony to glorify God. You begin to have insomnia. Your heart. Boom, boom. What's in the worry? They say you get BP. No be BP. Envy one killer. Because in my local parlance, there's a proverb. They said, Uche wakba. Onye nankea. If God performs an X-ray on your heart now for us to see what the content is, I may not be preaching on this altar. Is God talking to somebody? Envying's mother, drunkenness, revealings, and such like, of which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Give me the next verse. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace. This is the one we're talking about. Love, joy, peace, long suffering. We'll come back to that. But I want to establish peace. The works of the flesh that are checking your peace are those ones I told you to take note of. Go back to verse 20. Hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, sedition. These ones are the fleshly manifestation that are choking your peace. Some of us under the sound of my voice, someone's progress is a problem to you. Do you know, as you are now, some people wish you were dead. Some people wish you don't wake up. They wish you were fired from your job. Some wish your husband took a walk out of your life. Some wish your wife told you no, that this thing was not going to work anymore. There are some persons under the sound of my voice. Enemies are waking up seeing you each day and they are not happy. Can I prophesy to somebody? Anybody the devil has sponsored to take the peace of God in your life, I command them to go down 6 feet under. Amen.
Yes, sir.
2 Thessalonians,
yes, sir.
Chapter 3,
uh-huh.
In verse 16,
uh-huh.
The Bible says,
yes, sir.
And that Almighty God,
uh-huh.
shall give you peace,
amen.
By all means.
Amen.
He shall give you peace,
amen.
By all means.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what the devil is doing.
Yes, sir.
Receive the peace of God,
amen.
By all means.
Yes, sir.
It doesn't matter what your enemies are doing.
Uh-huh.
Receive the peace of God,
amen.
By all means.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what the economy is saying.
Yes,
I came to prophesy to Samba. Receive
God.
The peace of God,
amen.
By all means.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what your enemies are saying.
Yes,
I came to announce to Samba,
yes,
the God of prophetess Rose,
yes,
will give you peace,
amen.
By all means.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what your neighbors are saying. They can say,
yeah.
But they cannot alter it.
Amen.
They can say,
yes,
but they cannot alter it.
Amen.
Who say it and it cometh to pass,
uh-huh.
when the Lord commanded it not? Bible says, eyes had not seen,
yes,
ears had not heard,
uh-huh.
neither has it entered the heart of man. What the Lord has prepared for someone,
yes,
I prophesy,
hallelujah.
By the hand of Yeshua, the Lord give you peace.
Amen.
Give you peace in business.
Amen.
Give you peace in career.
Amen.
Give you peace in whatever you do.
Amen.
Give you peace in your marriage.
Amen.
Give you peace in your life.
Amen.
Give you peace in your health.
Amen.
Give you peace in your life.
Amen.
Give you peace in your head.
Amen.
For I wish above all things,
yes,
that you prosper.
Amen.
I don't know whom God is talking to. Anytime God wants to give you peace,
uh-huh.
He begins to prosper you. Anytime God wants to bring peace,
yes,
into your family,
yes,
He shows you the way to prosper. For I wish above all things, that you prosper,
amen.
And be in health.
Amen.
I don't know whom God is talking to. The God of prophetess Rose,
uh-huh.
is bringing you peace,
amen.
By healing you tonight.
Amen.
He is bringing you peace,
amen.
By healing you tonight.
Amen.
Diabetes shall expire.
Amen.
High blood pressure shall expire.
Amen.
HIV will jump out.
Amen.
Evil sickness in that blood,
oh.
shall be terminated.
Amen.
I come against hepatitis.
Uh-huh.
Hepatitis 1, 2, 3. Ay, 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 ay. Leave that body now.
Amen.
Leave that body now.
Amen.
Leave that body now.
Amen.
I come against leukemia.
Amen.
I come against leukemia.
Amen.
Every blood cancer,
Jesus.
Every form of cancer,
Jesus.
In your body,
Amen.
Every ailment. You came here with tonight.
Amen.
The God of our mother,
yes,
shall show you mercy.
Amen.
He shall give you peace.
Amen.
He shall give you peace.
Amen.
He shall give you peace.
Amen.
By all means.
Amen.
He shall give you peace.
Amen.
By all means.
Amen.
He said the children,
yes,
the Lord has given to me.
Uh-huh.
They are for signs and wonders.
Yes,
I am praying for every parent here.
Amen.
Your investment in your children,
Amen.
Shall never be wasted.
Amen.
It shall never be in vain.
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 Amen.
Come unto me,
yes,
all ye that are labor and are heavy laden,
yes,
and I will give you peace.
Amen.
Can I prophesy?
Prophesy?
The God of peace shall give you peace.
Amen.
We call him the Prince of Peace.
Amen.
Yes, when the storm was raging,
uh-huh.
he came to the storm.
Yes,
he said, peace. Can I speak now?
Yes, sir.
Those two words didn't come together.
Uh-huh.
First of all, he used peace as an ID card.
Yes,
he said, peace.
Ooh.
If you read that scripture, you'll see a comma after peace.
Yes, sir.
The meaning of a comma is a pause.
Uh-huh.
Ayamana suwafala.
Yes, sir.
He said, peace. He presented peace.
Uh-huh.
He now said, be still.
Uh-huh.
Tonight I come here.
Uh-huh.
In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach.
Uh-huh.
In the name of that God who died and rose,
yeah.
after 3 days. The God of our mother prophet Rose.
Yes, sir.
I decree over your life. Peace.
Amen.
Peace.
Amen.
Still in your life.
Amen.
Peace be still in that situation.
Amen.
Peace be be still in that condition. Peace be still in that situation. Peace be still in that condition. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. I came to announce to someone, every access door the devil has found, that is the reason why your life is tormented, today I close that door. I didn't hear your amen like thunder. I close that door. I close that door. I close that door. For whatever thing my heavenly Father has not planted, it shall be rooted out. 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 The God of our mother is uprooting something from somebody's life. Whatever represents crisis in your life, receive the peace of God. I didn't hear your amen like thunder. I didn't hear your amen like thunder. Whatsoever thing represents crisis, it is taken away today. It is taken away today. It is taken away today. Crisis have come to an end. If you believe God, let your amen sound like thunder. One of the profound ways to get peace is to engage in war.
I hear you, sir.
Am I in a saliva? Hey! One of the profound ways to find peace is to do what? Engage in war. How many of you are ready to fight? The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but not in every case. Not in every case. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Not in every... Because somebody cannot just come and slap you and you start smiling the way you are smiling like this. What will you do?
Fight.
It is not in all cases. To every general rule, there are exceptions. One of those exceptions is that if you need peace, get ready to engage in war.
Yes, sir.
Because if they can feed them, Pastor Fidel is a very, very wicked man. You are a good man. I'm just giving an illustration.
Yes, sir.
If he's a very, very wicked man, and me now, a very, very gentle man, what will he do to me? He will eat me like a piece of meat in his plate. Is God talking to somebody here?
Yes, sir.
But when he's a very wicked and violent man, and me too, I'm wicked and violent, anytime we meet each other, we'll come to a compromise where we'll understand that we have boundaries. You'll be waving me, I'll be waving him. He got to wave me, I go there. If I bow to him, he bow to me too.
Yes, sir.
Because he knows that what he can do to me, I can equally do to him.
I hear you, sir.
I don't know whom God is talking to here.
I'm the one.
Can I pray for someone?
Yes, sir.
Every enemy that said you will not see the end of this year. Fire! What will you say?
Fire!
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You may be seated in heavenly places.
Thank you, sir.
I never knew that Bible says, in two scriptures, that Gaza will become desolate. He said, Gaza has sinned against God and they are going to be wiped out. So it's happening now. Some people that call themselves Hamas, which some other people in Nigeria are now taking sides with them to come and do protests in Nigeria over what is happening in Israel. The people call Hamas, they are the terrorist leadership in the Palestinian side of Israel. Let me cut the long story short. 1947, there was a treaty that was done by the United Nations Organization that brought Israel back to their official land. That their official land was desolate. How many of us remember what Adolf Hitler did to Jewish men in Germany? He killed 4 million Jewish men in a day. In 2 weeks, he had consumed 6 million Jews. They were roasting them in fire. Pour fuel, burn them, the people of Israel. I went to South Africa some years ago and they took me to a settlement where Jewish people are. And I was talking to a particular Jewish pharmacist and he told me something. He said they don't send their children to school until they are about to enter that secondary school to write exam or go to university. I asked them why. He said a Jew can never bow to another person. That's why you don't see them walking anywhere. When you see them, they are professionals, medical doctors, engineers, and all of that. But the time came when God wanted to deal with them. He scattered them all over the world. If you go to the United States Marine, 50% of the Marine officers are Jewish. When you hear that a man is a Jew, he's an Israelite. Praise the Lord. A lot of them scattered all over the world in Germany. No matter what they did, Adolf Huss did to clear them out of Germany. If you go to Frankfurt and they show you the buildings of Jewish people. In fact, they have the money. You know, Frankfurt is they say it's the center of Europe. I don't know how. But they have all the money in Frankfurt, at least 70%. You come to a street, you see some guys, they are looking different in color. They are all Jewish. Praise the Lord. God blessed them so much because of the covenant he had with Jacob. Now, after that treaty, Israelites began to return back from their different places. And they were given a small land where they occupied. And from them till now, it has been war because enemies surrounded them. If it's not Egypt, it will be Palestinian. It will be another place. It will be another place. Iran hates Israel like whatever you think. But no matter the hatred, God has given Israel a pattern of peace. When Baba Adeboye say he stands with Israel, some people, they verse. I say, yes. If I don't stand with Israel, who will I stand with? If you say you stand with Hamas, you are saying I stand with Boko Haram. And against God. Balaam was paid by Balak. He said, prophesy against these people. Said, they grow too much. That was Adolf Hitler's offense with Israel, with Jewish. He began to wipe all of them just to make sure he clears them. The more you kill them, the more they prosper. It didn't start with Adolf Hitler, it started with Pharaoh. The more they were suffering them, the more they were growing. The more they were carrying capacity. So God taught Israel that anytime I want to forgive you, the best way to find peace is to war. When Hamas bombarded Israel, went in, carried people hostage, carried people captive, Israel came out and cried out, said, you now know our way. We will go back to that way. There are some of you here. I am not asking you to carry any arm or do anything, but you have your mouth to kabash in the night. There are some certain enemies when they do. You know, I've started seeing some posts on social media where people began to say, in Nigeria, we pray. But in Israel, they are fighting battle. Israel does not have to go and pray. Because what is happening to them is more than the other one. Abi, what is happening to them is not within prayer. If they are praying, these people will be coming and cutting off their head. Is God talking to somebody here? But a video emerged where their soldiers were going to war. What did they do? They started marking the sign of the cross on their forehead. I thought they say Israelites are not Christians. Like they practice Judaism. Why are they doing sign of the cross? Is God talking to somebody here? Is God talking to somebody? So they have a particular pattern to pursue peace. And when Hamas bombarded them, when they came out, cried to the world and said, this thing will not be swept under the camel. In 48 hours, after their bombardment, they told the people in Gaza, if you know you are a civilian, leave. Because that land has to be desolate. There are some times, if your enemies are not brought to their knees, you will not have peace. Oh, come on. I don't know whom God is talking to here.
Uh-huh.
There are some persons under the sound of my voice.
Yes, sir.
They have mocked you too much.
Uh-huh.
It is time to return back to God.
Yes, sir.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. I am, but they are spiritual.
Yes, sir.
To the pulling down of strongholds.
Yes, sir.
Casting down of imagination.
I hear you, sir.
Ah, can I prophesy to someone?
Yes, sir.
Anybody who say you will never have peace,
yeah.
I command them to rest in peace.
Amen.
Consumers of peace, number one, hatred. Genesis chapter 27, in verse 29, when Jacob was taking the blessing of his brother Esau. And after taking it, Esau said, I will kill my brother when I find him. It was a statement of hatred. But it's not just a statement of hatred, it was a statement from emotion. How many of us remember when Apostle Paul wrote in the book of Romans chapter 9, verse 15 and 16? He said, Jacob have I loved, Esau have I hated. And then I've been asking a question until God spoke to me by 3 a.m. on Saturday night. I said, if God is going to say Esau he has hated, Jacob he loved, first of all, how will God be a hater? Amen. I now understood that those were part of the statements that Apostle Paul made to buttress his point. God will not be a hater of anybody. Is God talking to somebody here? Because he's all-knowing. He's the Almighty. He does what he likes to do. We can't question him. And then at the later part of that story, he says, is God unjust? He said, no, God is not unjust. Now, let me tell you what that thing means. The lineage of Esau are called the Edomites. Another name for Esau is Edom. So when you see the king of Edom in 2 Kings chapter 3 verse 27, where he slashed the head of his son, that man was from the tribe of Esau. There were people that eventually didn't know God, as it were. Because God has already established his covenant with Jacob. Is God talking to somebody here? God has established his covenant with Jacob. Now, in a particular scripture, the Bible says, and God supported the Israelite against the Edomites. Now, Apostle Paul now translated it by emotion that God hates Esau because he is the lineage father of the Edomites. God cannot hate. Now, hatred is what spans from the heart of man because of an offense. Sometimes you see brother wishing that the brother should die. Something has led to it. Some came as a result of parental preference. Me and mommy have discussed and said, we can have preferred kids, but we cannot show them preference by that preferment. Sometimes there is an attunement you have with one. You know, you keep connecting with that one because he relates with you very well. That does not mean you should now take the one you relate with very well above the other one. It can bring terrible hatred. Is God talking to somebody here? The Bible speaking concerning Cain and Abel. I think that's the book of Genesis chapter 4 from verse 1 to 18. Cain was a farmer. Abel was a livestock man. At the end of the day, they made their sacrifices. And God took the one that Abel had done. Hallelujah. And then Cain became angry. He hated his brother and killed his brother. One of the things that Cain never enjoyed, even though he later built a city, because theologians said, after all, Cain eventually built a big city. That was a particular verse in the Bible. But one thing Cain ever lost was peace. Any money you have that has no peace in it will kill you. Any property you have you can't occupy in peace will destroy you. Anything you have that becomes a sight to other people that you cannot enjoy in peace is a killer to you. So Cain built cities, but one thing he never found was peace. God told him, he said, you'll be a vagabond and a wanderer. You will stroll from pillar to post. That means peace will never become. Whenever you are hating, what you are doing is to chase peace away from your life. The moment you go into the business of hatred, you are chasing peace away. Number two, consumer of peace is envy. Genesis 30 verse 1. And when Rachel saw that she bare Jacob no children, Rachel envied her sister. See what envy now bring. It didn't end there. Envied her sister. And said unto Jacob, give me children or else I die. Envy can make somebody commit suicide. Envy. 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 Is so suicidal. It can make a man commit suicide. Auntie, uncle, brother, sister, let us stop envying another. The Bible says, they that compare themselves with themselves are not wise. What will make you begin to compare yourself? Is it not envy? The seed of envy is the attacker of peace. A lady who decided to marry a man that his sister, her sister was already married to, was already competitive in nature. If it's not competition, why are you envying me? Why should I envy you? I should compliment you. I don't know whom God is talking to here. Eh? I should do what? Compliment you. Look at what a sister was saying concerning her sister. Her own blood sister, her senior sister, the same father, the same mother, said her husband, I will commit suicide if I don't have a child. A reasonable person, even though no matter how the flesh is moving you, can the spirit tell you, adopt some children from this your sister. Your own, they come. You don't understand. Leah gave birth to children, or she gave birth to 12. Was she the one that forced herself into Jacob? No. Circumstances have made it like that. Somehow, it happened like that. But where is the role of peace? Why can't you be at peace to support your brother or support your sister? Give me Matthew chapter 11, verse 1. And it came to pass when Jesus had made an end of commanding his 12 disciples, he departed thence to teach and to preach in their cities. Go ahead. Now, when John had heard in the prison, the third consumer of peace is what we call rot. Now, when John had heard in the prison the works of Jesus, he sent two of his disciples and said unto them, art thou he that should come, or do we look for another? John don't verse. This is the person where God give ministry. Say, you go there inside wilderness, preach your gospel there. I keep people there for you. He now decided to come to the palace to harass Herod. God gave him a ministry in the wilderness. And he decided to come to the palace. He said unto him, he was annoyed. He was in wrath. Are you the one that I told people that I don't have the power to lose your shoes? Are thou he that will come? I have been in prison. You didn't come to see me. Look at what happened. Just like some people are angry. Mommy, you know, they call person. And me, my pastor, they send me message every day. That's why pastor na pastor. Prophet na prophet. The line where prophet they attend to, different from the line where pastor they attend to. A prophet is the one who is sent to you. Who is sent to you. And he has your data. He has everything to operate with. A pastor is the shepherd, the caretaker. Jesus answered and said unto them, go and show John again those things which ye do hear and see. Go and tell John inside that prison the things which you did hear and see. The blind receive their sight, and the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear. The dead are raised up, and the poor have the gospel preached to them. That is my ministry. That is the ministry God sent to mommy. That's what God asked mommy to come and do. So tell them that the blind still see. The message of liberation is still preached to the poor. Yes, sir. The lame still walk. And blessed is he whosoever that shall not be offended. A lot of us have lost our peace because we are offended. What is the offense? If now between husband and wife, when I know we feel settled, what is the offense? Waiting to make husband and wife their house 2 weeks, they never talk to each other. Do you know that when there is no peace at home, prayers can never be answered? Prayers can never be answered. There is no peace at home. How can you be with your wife, with your husband in the same house for 3 days when I never talk to each other? And after, you will come sing for choir. You come do usher. You come join protocol. Mommy, help me pray for this business. This business, I go make 1 billion. You are going to be poorer because you have not given peace a chance. Blessed is he who is not offended in me. Who are you offended in here? If I am the person, please forgive me. If he is your brother seated beside you, please forgive him. Offense. Offense will rob a man of anything. This is what killed John the Baptist, not the girl that danced. What killed John the Baptist was that he was offended in the Savior. He was offended in the Master. How many times have you been offended with our mother in the Lord? Wrath is so dangerous. It's a killer of peace. You vex. You are angry. You vex with everybody. You are angry with unveiling the veil. You are angry with elder. You are angry with everybody. You are angry with everybody. Blessed is the man who shall not be offended in me. The man was killed by offense. Number five, consumer of peace. We call it strife, anger, bitterness, disagreement, conflict. They are all children of strife. 90% of men of God are in strife with their wife, who are doing well, like Mommy Rose. The moment they saw the seed growing up, they killed it. They will steer you into strife to begin to compete with who you should complement. Peace will leave you when you enter into strife. Be on your feet wherever you are.
Our sister has come to give God the praise for breaking the power of addiction from her life. She said for 15 solid years and more, she was addicted to alcohol. Our sister said, as a human being, as an individual, she has tried and struggled with this battle for 15 solid years. She has done all that she could, humanly speaking, to break this satanic siege on her life. But she says, at each time she tries to break it, the enemy tries to intensify the urge for alcohol. And then she made contact with this ministry, and to the glory of God, in that meeting, Mommy prayed and broke the power of addiction from the lives of people in that particular service. And she said, from that day, she believed that that was her word. From that day till now, till eternity, she said that urge for alcohol has died forever, and it's been one solid month now she has not tested alcohol. Can you please celebrate Jesus for breaking this addiction? He said he has come to give God a praise for healing him. I said the enemy plagued him with very terrible and excruciating pain on the chest that we usually extend to the back. It looks to me like it is just like a sign of ulcer at his very young age. He said he had tried all forms of medications, but it was not subsiding. And then he remembered that he had a dose of the Ogula sand from the Ogula prayer mountain. He said he took some of it and then just applied it at that particular spot where he was hurting. He said, like magic, to the glory of God, the pains took off, everything disappeared. He said, today he's standing healed and healthy. He has come to give God the praise for healing him. And secondly, he said the sister took him, and then with all forms of complication, they were scared that she was not going to be able to bring forth successfully. He said, but God put the enemy to shame. The enemy was mesmerized, and today the sister put to bed successfully, and he has come to return all the praise. Mother and child are both doing well, and he's not taking it for granted.
Our sister Doris Edwin is here to return all the glory to God for giving her first grandchild. Hallelujah. Celebrate God. Return all the glory to God for the privilege to be a grandmother. There is no much to be said about that. It's all about thanksgiving to God. Praise the Lord. She's not taking it for granted. You can see she's all excited to the glory of God. Hallelujah.
Sister Okeke Susan, she said she has come to return all the praise to God. She said in her residence, in her house, there's been this demonic object that's been moving in her ceiling. Very aggressive and very forceful. They say in the middle of the night, this object will move around the whole ceiling, disturbing her peace, disturbing and then preventing her from enjoying a good sleep. She said she knows that her house is not a place where rats or cats will just enter. She knew it was a demonic agent that was there, but she didn't have the spiritual capacity to arrest that satanic entity. She said this particular day she was connected with her mommy online, and mommy declared and said, there is somebody watching me right now. There is a demonic agent that has been sent from the village to monitor your life and to monitor your destiny. But mommy declared and said, right now, as I speak, that satanic entity comes under fire right now, and you will no longer see it again. Our sister said she jumped up and screamed amen, and she said, to the glory of God, from that day till today till eternity, that satanic agent has been sent back to hell. She now sleeps peacefully, and she has come to return all the praise to God. She said secondly, just few weeks ago, she was opportune to join the Ogbula voices as a worker in the house. She says since she joined the workforce of this ministry, her doors, financial doors, have opened left, right, and center. She said her business have taken a new shift. God is blessing on all sides, and she's not taking it for granted. She says she noticed that since she became a worker in this ministry, God has opened up her destiny. Her financial level has exploded, and she's not taking it for granted. She has come to return all the praise to God. She said about a month ago, she discovered that there was this swelling on her legs. Her legs started swelling, and then initially she thought it was just a normal pain, and then over time it will go. She took some antibiotics and then tried to treat herself. She said, but the pain persisted. After a while, someone recommended that she go see this native herbal people, so they could just mix some stuff for her, and then she was going to be fine. Her sister said they did all of those things, yet the pain persisted. And then she went to the hospital, saw the doctor. She said the moment the doctor saw her, the doctor screamed, examined, and said, this pain is really a serious one. The only option we have now, we are considering amputating your leg. Now, she said the doctors did all they could, and then no help from anywhere. The pain refused to subside. When the doctors told her that they were contemplating amputating the leg, that was when she knew that the matter was a serious one. She knew that it was not just ordinary. And then the mother said, no, we cannot be connected to the voice of solution and then allow them and amputate your leg. We will go to church and let the God of Mommy Rose heal you. They came to church, were part of the service, where brutal declarations were being released. And then after the service, went to the Ogbula prayer mountain, collected some sand, went back that same day, applied the sand on the leg. Her sister said for a while she was unable to walk. She was unable to put that leg on the ground. She said, but after that exercise, she woke up, and by the power of God, she was able to put that leg on the ground. The next day, she was able to walk, and day after day, she kept on recovering. And today, you can see the both legs. And God has healed her completely. The pains have took off. The swelling has gone down, and she's completely whole to the glory of God.
Favor Chukuma told me on their way coming to church this evening, inside the bus that was contracted to bring them to church from Kabusa, she said on their way to church, the tire to the vehicle removed, started shaking. And it was a situation that would have led to a very fatal accident. But our God was with them. He preserved their vehicle with a shaking tire from where the tire got detached. Till they got to the junction here, before the tire completely pulled out. Celebrate Jesus. We have seen cases of this magnitude where people entered buses or transport system, and when the tire pulls out, there is a summon sort of the vehicle, and everybody inside the vehicle get to lose their life. But these ones, they had the same situation on their way to church. The tire to the vehicle pulled out. Most of them, maybe not mechanically inclined, did not understand what was going on. But the driver was able to sustain it by the grace of God that was traveling with him. It would have been a situation whereby we are crying for this number. Just imagine crying for this number of people. Say, God forbid. But the plan of the wicked one was truncated. And today we have them in this number giving glory to God.
Spirit, right now I'm dependent on you. Show yourself so strong. In the fatigue, please stand up. Stay fast. Flap your wings around. Touching every soul. Come touch us one more time.